there, and welcome to Lunch Bites with Lainey.
So we look at a lot of things here that are vintage for me, so they're obviously vintage for you. But today we're going to talk about something that's a little bit more vintage from you. Mm-hmm. There was a show that Lainey used to love to watch. It came out in 2009, and it ran for like four seasons or five seasons. It was done in 2013, so from the time you were born mm-hmm. until the time you were four, this thing was on TV. And you loved this show and watched it religiously. And I have to say, I enjoyed watching it with you, and I'll get into the reasons why later. But it was called
Fresh Beat Band.
Right, the Fresh Beat Band. It was on Nickelodeon. And it was a show about these four young musicians, mm-hmm. right, who went to music school. And in addition to playing a musical instrument, they were a band. They were called the Fresh Beat Band, obviously. Mm-hmm. And they played musical instruments, they sang, they danced, and they had these little adventures kind of thing.
Yeah.
Right? And it was a live-action series. Mm-hmm. And it was on Nickelodeon for those years. And why did you like this thing so much?
I liked it because I love the way they dance, and I like the story because they're really creative with it. So it's like Marina, who's one of the musicians, would play along with Kiki, and they would all play along with each other, and it would be so cool to see all of them just having an adventure with each other. But also when they would do the dances, the choreography, mm-hmm. I really liked it because they would all do the same thing at the same time, and they mm-hmm. would have their solos, kind of.
So. It was very energetic choreography and very eye-catching. I want to say Mandy Moore was the choreographer, and this was around the same time period that High School Musical and things like that were out. It was very popular, and I want to say she might have been a choreographer on some of those types, maybe yeah. not High School Musical, but some of the other movies that were popular at that time. So it's very energetic. It could be an ad for a dental It could be a dental commercial because they all have these big smiles and beautiful teeth. Even the backup dancers, it's all about the teeth, right? And their smiles and their energy was infectious, right? So you had the four main characters were Kiki and Marina, who you already mentioned, mm-hmm. and then Twist and Shout, who are the two guys in the band. Yeah. Twist was he was a DJ, right? He was like an MC.
I think of him as the funny one.
Yes, and he's very funny. And then Shout would play the piano. And the two main, well, I guess they all sing to an extent, but Marina's a good singer, mm-hmm. but Kiki and Shout were the main singers. Yeah. Like, and then, you know, Twist kind of raps.
Yeah.
And of course, Marina did have a very nice voice mm-hmm. as well. And they all go to music school.
Mm-hmm.
And this thing plays like, I don't know, if you're from my generation, you might think of, it's a live action series, but they talk to the camera because they're talking to their audience. Their audience mainly was probably little ones like you were at the time. and it reminded me of like Great Space Coaster or maybe the New Zoo Review or something like that from when I was a kid. Anything live action in that vein. And at this time period, Disney Channel was running Imagination Movers, I think, which was a similar kind of setup, and then it was live action, and you had four main characters, and they would talk to the audience a little bit. So it was, that's something that really doesn't exist right now. I mean, all those shows are off the air, and it doesn't exist, but I liked it because it was a throwback to that kind of thing from when I was a kid. The sets were obviously sets. They're in a studio, and you know, their home and their street and their music school are 5 seconds apart and everything. And that reminded me a lot of those shows from when I was a kid. But I liked it because it was nostalgic in that way.
Right.
And they are very fun. They're very committed to what they're doing, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, no matter how silly the thing is that they're dealing with.
There was one with a balloon and it would like follow them around.
Right.
And they would just have a fun time with the balloon.
Right. And there's a lot of things, but there was always something with music that was involved in it, of course, because they were a band. They did a couple of special shows. One was called The Wizard of Song, where they did a take on The Wizard of Oz, and they used their music, their original songs, in there instead.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say it was Jason Mraz that was the wizard. So he had a pretty big name person. Every time that song of his comes on the radio, I think of the Wizard of Song because he uses his song in it. So it must be that he must have had a kid. It must be his kid loved the show and he wanted to be in the show. You know what I mean? And so he asked and they put him in there. So there were a couple other, I can't think of the actress's name, but she was, She was on Roseanne as Becky. When the original Becky left, she came in and played Becky for a couple seasons. Sarah, I think, is her first name. Sarah Chalk. She was also on Scrubs. She's in there, and she was in the same episode. She was one of the good witches.
Yeah.
Right? And she had So there were some fairly decent names that were involved in it here and there, but it was mainly these four people, and there's a couple other characters, like Miss Piccolo is the music teacher.
Yes.
Reed is the guy who owns the music store. Melody.
Yeah, the one that owns the groovy smoothie.
And she sells smoothies, and she's a great singer. She's a great voice. And then there's the backup dancers.
Yeah.
And they're very good. And, similar to the Monkees TV show, again, that live action thing where they talk to the audience and they're in on the joke. they're getting these goofy situations, and then their original songs are worked into the plot each week.
Like Bananas.
Right. And the song would be, they wear the same outfits in every episode, and that's because when they cut to the musical number, like Bananas is one of the numbers that you were talking about, that was filmed way back, and then they just plug it into the episode. So that's why they're wearing the same clothes, because it's the same, they plug it in there. But it doesn't bother me. I enjoy the music. Music's catchy. It's fun. Little kids will love it, and you loved it then. So
I still love it.
Right. And I was going to say, recently it's reappeared. Nickelodeon.
Junior.
Nick Jr. has it on their website. It's also on Pluto TV. And so you've rediscovered it, and you started watching it. So now, being 10, so this is where the vintage piece comes in. You loved it when you were little, up through when you when it went off the air when you were 4. Do you still like it?
I absolutely love it.
Yeah. She's going through her second childhood at 10, because she got up and she was dancing and singing all the songs, and you remembered every word of every song. And I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it as much. It's very much for me like Pokemon with Colton. I love going to Pokemon movies with Colton to watch how much he enjoys it. And I get a very similar feeling out of this, watching how much you enjoy it. But in all honesty, there's a nostalgia factor to it for me. So I actually like it, and I think the actors are very invested in it. And, I see, there's a lot of criticism thrown at it. Probably the plots are hokey and it's overacted and this thing. But you got to remember who the audience is. The intended audience is little kids, and I know for a fact little kids loved it. You loved it so much that what happened? What are you wearing there?
This is a jacket from when Daddy took me to a Fresh Beat Band concert when I was really little.
Right, and you, me, your mom, and I think we went to two. We went to one at the place. The place where I work has a concert, a summer concert series, and they came there. And then we went
again.
Which
was really cool.
Right, and then they came the next summer, about an hour away from where we live, to another concert venue. And we went there, and Colton was a baby. So we all went, and he was there. And it was that's when you got the jacket. So that was a lot of fun.
This one's Shouts jacket.
And so, because there's an episode where the jacket comes in.
Yes.
Right? And after it went off the air, then it came back in a different form. It came back as a cartoon. And the same four actors voiced their parts, but it was a different premise. It was called the Fresh Beat Band of Spies.
Yes.
And so it had a little bit more of a Josie and the Pussycats thing kind of going on, where they were trying to, take down some evil crime person or whatever.
Yeah.
And in all honesty, you liked it when it was on.
Yeah.
I think you would have liked it more had you not seen the live action series first.
I think if you watched the live action series first, and then Fresh Beat Band of Spies, I think Fresh Beat Band of Spies is kind of like, what's going on with Fresh Beat Band?
Right.
But if it's the other way around, what's going on with Fresh Beat Band of Spies?
They're two very different shows. They only share the fact that the characters have the same names.
Yes.
The situations they're in are completely different. I think they bring Reed in. Reed sort of assigns them to cases.
Mm-hmm.
So he's the only common other character. And
then they bring a monkey, Bo, in.
Yeah, Bo Monkey. And then they have some of the music. I think there's a little bit of music. So this is like, it really is more like Josie and the Pussycats or Scooby-Doo kind of thing.
Scooby-Doo.
Yes, it really doesn't, it's not the same. It's really not the same. It's a completely different show. It just has the same characters in it. So it's one of those situations. So what would you say about this? Would you say to check it out? I mean, who would you recommend it for?
I think that you like it.
Well, yeah, but I'm not sure too many other 50-year-old guys are going to like this show, in all honesty.
But I think that kids ages at least up to 10 could check it out, see if they like it. If they do, keep on watching it because it's a great series, in my opinion.
And the music is it's an earworm. It sticks in your head. You remembered every word. And as you were singing, I remembered the words. And I remember sitting on the couch with you during the summer and watching. There were episodes that you loved so much, we would watch them again and again and again. And for the parents out there, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But
and sometimes when Bananas would come on, it's my favorite song. Right. We would watch that one over.
Yeah. So if you take it for what it is and you understand where they're coming from with it, you can enjoy it as a family. It's kind of fun. So again, I'm not going to say that this is highbrow entertainment in a sense. It's just entertainment. So, but it was fun. You still like it. Yeah, so it's a lot of fun. Okay, yummy or crummy for you? I know where you're going to go with this.
Well, there was one episode where there was a conga line and they would go conga, conga, conga. So I'm going to say yummy, yummy, yummy.
Wow, you really worked for that. I'm not even going to put a joke in there because you worked so hard for that. Yeah, I'm going to give it a yummy too for the reasons I said before. You know, check it out. It's on Pluto TV. It's on Nick Jr. You can find it on the internet. It's free. It's kind of fun. If you have little kids, I'm sure they'd enjoy it. All right, we'll see you next time.
Make sure you subscribe.
And take care.